toxins you have in your house,
True.
period, the
True.
better.
I'm moving
You know?
too, so
And 'cause
I
that
think about that.
toxifies the earth.
Yeah,
You know,
that's
it's just
true.
going down the drain.
Yeah.
You know, there's an easier way. You know, so the less the better. You know, kind of.
I'm trying to learn all the things and make me be healthy.
Yeah, the more just it's like it's that's why I was saying it. That's the whole lifestyle is a
Yes.
spectrum
Yes.
from, you know, from going very natural from natural toothpaste, deodorant, lotions, body products to cleaning products, everything. Because we breathe all of that in, and a lot of us are using like household sprays and
Yeah.
you know, plug-ins that are toxic.
Yeah.
And we can
You can use those essential oils in
essential oils in
that's
the diffuser that actually has health benefits
yes.
as opposed to having something that's going off 24 hours a day that's actually toxifying
yeah.
your lungs. Yeah, so it's a spectrum of
health.
Yeah.
So I have a diffuser, Doc, in most of my rooms.
Okay.
So that's helping with the bleach, yes?
You gotta just I think for you just think of cutting the bleach use in half and then work your way down.
Okay.
Yeah. But they really do have some good cleaners, wipes and everything that are really good. But we're not that dirty. We over sanitize
yeah.
a bit, you know. I mean, I like clean
yeah.
environments.
Yeah.
But it doesn't have to be sterile. Yeah, but the diffuser's good. And you're getting a good essential oil.
I have lemon and eucalyptus, peppermint.
Yeah.
Those are good. Yeah, all those are really good. I might look into some that are specifically for good for the lungs because I need some cleaning.
Okay, I'll look into that.
Yeah, and definitely you're not using plug-ins and sprays and
yeah.
all those kind of things.
So I am.
Yeah, I figured. It seemed like I can tell you that's
Her
high.
They're not good.
No, they coat the lining of the lungs with a slight film, and over time it just fills up, and that's very carcinogenic. So.
And they're by the bed, every bed.
And you're breathing that in 24 hours. So unplug those all. The diffuser is more than enough.
Okay.
Just use that more often. And make sure you're cleaning your diffusers regularly so there's no mold or anything. Don't bleach them.
How do I clean it? Like, I forgot
vinegar.
Vinegar water.
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, the plug-ins are not good, and neither are the popular household sprays. You can get some natural sprays that use essential oils
yeah.
as well.
Yeah.
So.
Okay.
Yeah, household products are the hidden toxifiers for a lot of people. Yeah, and that's what we're going to be talking about at the summit because
yeah.
it's a holistic lifestyle.
Yeah.
So it's not just the food. It's you know
yeah.
that's why we're including dentistry.
Yeah.
Everything that touches your body within your environment matters.
Yeah.
So especially what we're breathing. You know, we're in a house sleeping and we're having these. Fragrances go off all the time. It's not healthy, and that's why we have so many mystery diseases because we don't realize how many ways we're toxifying ourselves.
I have a question. So sometimes I burn incense. Is that good or bad?
I'm a little torn. It's not really the best.
Yeah.
I have just transitioned to just using essential oil, just because of the residue from the incense.
What do you think about that that lamp? That
salt lamp? Those are good.
In your bedroom?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, anywhere.
So, I read something that you can put in your bedroom. So, what does it do?
So, it's supposed to ionize
the air.
So, which is a good thing. The more ions that are in the air, the more natural it is. Like, you're in the ocean way out, that's like the most ionized air you could be breathing, very pure. Healthy, there's not a lot of toxins and things in it. So the salt lamps help change the air and helps break up the magnetic infiltration that we get from Wi-Fi and phones and everything.
Yeah.
Which you need, especially since it was like, even here, right next to me, a salt lamp would be good to help break that up. So that those are good.
I know this is not about food. Do you know anything about diodes?
Diodes?
Yeah, something you put on your phone to keep.
Oh, yeah, they have the EMF blockers.
Yeah,
those are good. Yeah, I have used those. Okay. I need to get some more. So it helps break down the radiation that you get from the cell phone. And there's, even when you're not using it, there's radiation coming from it. So you can buy a little sticker.
I've seen them and I've read about them, but.
Yeah, you just put it on the phone or in your computer as well. And,
it's so much.
So my massage, so I know some people that use the crystals and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
I don't really understand much about crystals. So same as like the salt lamp, does it ionize or depends on the crystal?
Yeah, I don't know if it ionizes. I'm not sure. I haven't done a lot of work with crystals,
mm-hmm.
but the main thing is they have different vibrations.
Yeah.
So that's why people kind of gravitate to those things. Because they're trying to either raise their vibration or change the energy that they're feeling or, you know, trying to transmit. So everything does have a vibrational pattern, and I guess crystals have it in a stronger way.
Okay.
So when you have them on or on your body or near you, they can help change the vibrational output.
Yeah, because I have some rose quartz, and when I was supposed to symbolize love, and I wear an opal on the rose, so. I have to read more into so to see if it's working or not.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and then the quality of the crystal size and all that matters too. So
that's a whole other science.
It is. It's very interesting, and we haven't learned a lot about our energy and vibration, which is.
I told me to use amethyst, so I bought all these little amethyst crystals.
Uh huh.
Don't ask me nothing else. I don't know.
There's something to it. We just don't know enough about it.
I mean, when people talk to you about it,
it makes sense.
You know, you look and see.
Well, I mean, because, you know, a lot of times we kind of just dismiss things, but everything does have a vibration that you could actually measure. Everything, inanimate objects. So everything has a frequency, just like a radio. So that's where you get things like, where you get into the law of attraction and things like that, because your vibration connects with similar vibrations, and that's why bad luck is not really true. It's just your vibration is on that wavelength, so you just keep there. Raising the vibration raises it to something more positive.
Yeah.
So I definitely am a believer in that. So, you know, shifting energy. I mean, you can shift energy pretty quick in a room. Everybody feels energy, you know? You know, when somebody's very angry, like they're, you can feel that energy without getting that close to them, right? That's energy, because that vibration is so strong. You know, when you're very upset, you can feel that energy as soon as you walk in the room. You don't know what's going on, but you know something is not
going on.
Yeah, that. So we feel energy. It's just that we haven't been trained to know about it.
I thought it was really in my head, like, let's say my boyfriend's upset. I'm like, okay, he's upset. I don't even have to look at him.
You
can
feel it. Yeah. And the more in tune you are with whomever it is, the quicker and easier it is to pick it up, and then you become more sensitive to it. And you can just kind of read people's energy. So it's a whole nother
science.
It really is. It's very interesting. And it's one of the most powerful ones, because it's all in your control. So, so our food has vibration and energy.
Yes.
That's why, you know, eating dead things tend to weigh us down. If you're that's not life anymore. That's a lower level energy. So it kind of takes you opposite of life force and energy. And that's why when people go more toward a raw diet, you feel a lot lighter and things like that, because you have a better, you're getting better energy from that food. So.
You see your way.
Oh.
I was gonna say to cut up vegetables to derive different energy or different uses?
That's a good question. I'm not sure about the energy, probably. I mean, you know, I tend to like lots of raw things shredded, because they're just easier to eat. I guess it's kind of pre-processing it a little bit. You know, it definitely changes the flavor, the way you chop, especially raw veggies. Definitely changes the flavor, not just the texture. It's like, I don't like carrot chopped up, but I like shredded carrots. just tastes completely different to me,
mm-hmm.
because you're just able to get more of the flavor out of it. So especially when you go into a raw diet, having things like a mandolin to slice things thinly and things like that, and shredding, I think definitely makes the food taste better if it changes the energy. I don't know, probably.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't looked into that. I wouldn't be surprised. Yeah.
What about that zoodle?
Zoodles?
The spiral line.
Yeah, I love that. That's
great.
You
use that?
Yeah. Yeah, you can do a lot with that.
Yeah.
To make the zucchini noodles or sweet potatoes or beets or whatever. That texture.
They talk about it a lot.
The texture helps.
Yeah. I was at the PCR.
PCRM?
Yeah, I was at that session last night.
Okay.
And the lady said, it was a zoodle.
Uh-huh.
And she had these two machines.
Mm-hmm.
And she did all the.
Right.
So, my thing is cutting, doing a lot of cutting,
mm-hmm.
is not all that good, but it doesn't make a difference.
No. I mean, anytime you expose the veggie, you know, you start losing some of the vitamins.
Right.
So you want to do it right before you're going to eat it.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's for texture and taste. I think it's worth it. Because
honestly
wouldn't eat that bowl of veggies like that.
Because
I don't like it like that. But I would chop it up and eat it with some dressing on it or something. You know, or if it was smaller.
Well,
you know,
those are pretty big chunks.
They're pretty big, yeah.
Those are pretty big chunks. But
just
saying.
Most people don't want it like that. I mean, that's fine. But
that's where it comes from.
But that's where a little cutting, you're not adding heat
okay.
to it. You're not destroying anything. You're just kind of rearranging it.
But that spiralizer made everything like spaghetti.
Spaghetti thin. Uh-huh.
And that's good.
Yeah, if that's what you're looking for.
Oh.
Yeah, that's all the spiralizer does. So.
Yeah.
That's it.
I mean, I said myself, I don't know if I want spaghetti.
You don't have to do it for everything. Yeah.
I mean, zucchini,
right.
A couple things.
It's good for a couple of things. I like it for sweet potatoes and zucchini. So there's a lot.
Yeah, I do with zucchini.
That
is
for you. You can come on.
I didn't want to go in.
Okay.
Yeah, come in.
Yeah.
So what are some of the things that you might advise somebody if they're trying to change their diet and, you know, different things that you might want to look out for, just different helpful hints if they're
So I guess when you're trying to just change it to be healthier.
Yes.
Gotta really understand what healthy is. So because there's a lot of conflicting information out there. So kind of defining what that is first from a reliable source. So basically we're looking at things that are going to be anti-inflammatory and that are going to give us the best nutrition from the food. So that should include, and things that tend to be anti-inflammatory are going to be more plant-based foods that are fresh, more raw, less processed. So you want to kind of take stock of your current diet and figure out what you're going to replace. So when you take out something, you gotta figure out what you're gonna replace it with. Because generally, if you don't do that, you tend to, and so that leaves a void that then gets filled by whatever was there before, or worse. So so knowing what you're gonna replace some of your favorite things with, like when I say I'm not eating potato chips anymore, I'm like, okay, I'm gonna do kale chips now. I have a weakness for chips. This is probably a childhood thing. So. So I'll do kale chips, or I'll do seaweed, or something like that. Something that I can do that's going to give me a salty crunch or a texture or something, that when I get that normal habit craving, I can replace it with something else. So that would be one, having replacements, and then just having some good recipes or ideas of where you're going to get the healthy food. If you're a person who eats out, you have to know where you're going to go differently now, instead of where you've been going to get healthier food, or what you're going to order differently or something like that. Actually, just a plan, really, because the vague eating healthier doesn't work without a real plan. People say that all the time, you're going to eat healthier, and then they go to the same place or the same thing, you know, maybe leave this off, but it requires a little bit of a plan of what you're going to do. And so planning. And then always, you know, connecting with someone who you kind of vibe with in terms of the way they eat or their recipes or whatever, so that you have a go-to source to get recipes or food or information.
Okay. And what do you think is maybe like one or two things that people generally forget about or don't think about, and you're like, oh, you really should be eating this, or, you know, need to do this with your diet, or...
A lot of people start drinking enough water, I'd say, for starters. So they're surprised that they have constipation or problems going to the bathroom or not going every day. And then a look and see, and you're only maybe drinking 2 or 3 glasses of water a day. That's really one of the main things people aren't not doing, not getting enough water. And it really should be about half the weight in ounces of water, half your body weight in ounces of water a day as a guideline. So if you're really healthy, you might not get there, but you get an idea, I need to be drinking a lot of water, at least 8 glasses. So that's a starting point for the water, because that heals a lot of things. Just getting enough water heals things, because it carries out the toxins and a whole bunch of other things. And it makes the body work as it should, because it's based on, you know, water, from migraine headaches to back aches to just being toxic. Water is number one. And not drinking tap water. Number two is the right water. So it's got to be, you know, purified water. And then not getting enough fiber in the diet. So not just getting enough vegetables raw or cooked, for that matter, veggies. Because we tend to focus on the carbs and the protein and then not get enough of what really heals. The healing foods are the fruits, veggies, things like that. So usually that's what's missing.
Could you give me a sneak preview of Saturday?
A sneak preview? Yeah. Well, you have two of the speakers right here.
I understand that.
Doctor Victor, what are you going to be?
I know about the dinner party. I know you can tell me about the dinner party. It's over 20 years. I know all about it. I'm a,
Sneak preview. This is a sneak preview. Well, I guess if I'm being recorded, it's not much of a sneak, right? So talk about how dentistry involves the whole body and not just your teeth. How if you're going to decide that you want to make a change in your diet or, you know, in a lifestyle, that needs to be included also, because it's a part of your it's part of your body, and can't be separated. And how also a lot of disease processes are in your mouth, and if you have some things that are happening in your mouth, then you need to take care of them, as well as taking care of some of the other things that some of the other speakers are going to talk about. So just so to be holistic, you know, to include your whole body and every. And include your mouth in that. That is primarily what we're going to talk about in a nutshell sneak peek kind of thing. That's it.
All right, and then we have several other speakers on the side. About we added Dr. Baruch, Everlasting Life. He's going to be talking about disease and nutritional deficiencies.
Okay.
Of course, I'm super excited about everybody. Really, I really am. This is like. I'm always excited, but we have like just a great lineup. So Dondre Whitfield, who's an actor, but he's also a relationship coach and recently transitioned to a plant-based diet. So he's going to talk about healing emotionally and as well as diet, so okay. And his experiences with that. Because we were holistic again, our emotions play a big role, unresolved things. So he's going to be talking about that. Sean Shaw, she's an incredible motivational speaker. She's also recovered from breast cancer taking.
Okay.
So she's phenomenal. You're going to leave super energized. People really love her. And then Dr. James Loomis is going to be talking about, he is at the Barnard Medical Center, the medical director, which is affiliated with the PCRM.
Oh, the Barnard,
Committee.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He was speaking yesterday too.
Okay. Yeah, he's going to be talking a lot about the medical science behind nutrition and plant-based foods, and then I'm going to be doing a demonstration and talking about nutrition and
I know you.
Yes, you know.
I follow you, Dr.
So, and you have registered?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am, I'll be there.
And are you bringing someone?
No.
Have you told someone about it? You're keeping all this goodness
no.
to yourself?
No, you know how telling someone about, you have to talk to the people who are involved. Like, I'm involved with McCorda. You know, she just wrote a new book.
Who?
McCorda.
Oh, McCorda, Tracy.
Tracy. Yeah. She, her and her mother just wrote a new book.
Oh, really? Great.
Yeah.
Awesome.
I told them that I'm going, but, you know.
Yeah. Okay. Well, if you have friends who need to get on
they
track,
need to be.
Well, Tracy's.
Oh no, I'm just saying. I'm with him. That's why I'm involved. I've been taking classes from her for years.
Yeah.
I've been following you, but I'm saying my friends who are meat eaters, and I don't have the energy to deal with it. I'm trying to save myself.
Okay.
That's why I'm here.
Well, you could just give them a flyer.
Talk to meat eaters.
My
own family.
Yeah.
Ugh.
It's for everyone, regardless of where they are. It's just anyone who's trying to, you know, even if you're not like thinking about going plant-based, it's you just trying to learn about health and healing. This is where you want to be.
If you're eating swine, you're not thinking about health and healing.
Well, they might not know yet.
We've actually given out a lot of those.
Really? Great. Yeah. I appreciate that.
Yes.
That's awesome.
Is it too late to register?
It's not. No. We get quite a few people this last week. A lot of people like to...
We got 2 weeks. We got 2 weeks.
It's not quite 2 weeks. It's about 10 days.
What's the day?
It's 10 days.
It's the 17th. Yeah.
Oh, it's
okay.
Exactly 10 days. So
yeah.
You have 10 days.
Yeah.
You have less than 10 days. But yeah, a lot of us like to wait till last minute.
Yes, we do.
To commit to something. So, so if that's you, whoever's watching, get on it. Get on it. So that you'll have a plate of food when you get there.
Yes. People love food.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's the thing with planning these kind of things. We have to know ahead of time.
Yeah,
so
for sure.
There is adequate breakfast and lunch.
Yeah.
Since you're gonna be with us for you know, most of the day. So yeah, the sooner the better. And we've got some really great recipes. Most of them are my recipes that the facility is willing to prepare for us. So good stuff, not your traditional bland, boring, you know, boxed veggies and that's it kind of thing. It's good stuff. Yeah.
Are you gonna have vendors?
Yes, yes, there are definitely some really good exhibitors, vendors who are going to be there. So you can, you know, take what you've learned and, you know, learn more from them and also get some healthy, like, there's people doing alkaline water. And so you can ask them a lot of questions about that. You know, natural sanitary products for women and natural hair care and body products and all of that. So that, yeah, so it's a good place to connect. I always get stuff from there because it's like, I invite certain vendors because it's like, we need to have these type of people here because these are the kind of things that I use and I know that people want to, again, take it to the next level of using natural body products and all of that too. Chiropractors and the whole thing. So yeah, there's going to be a lot more to learn, not just from the speakers, but from the vendors and exhibitors as well. So yeah, we're super, super excited about it.
Thank you.
Yeah.